Hey guys, this is Arun aka TG from GadgetGuruBN.com. Today I'll be doing the review of the Vivo X60 Pro 5G. It's a flagship device from Vivo which launched in India for ₹49,990, which is similar to that of the OnePlus 9. Special thanks and mention to Channel 9 for letting me review this smartphone. You can contact Mr. Arjun for more info. Before we get started with this review, subscribe to ABN World with notifications on. Follow me on Instagram to never miss future updates. Also check out my One Link solution where you can keep track of all smartphones to compare and buy your favorite smartphone all in one place. So let's dive in. Inside the box, you'll find the device itself, 33-watt fast charger, Type-C cable, SIM tool, 3.5mm to Type-C converter, earphones, case, and user manual. The design is simple and neat, which looks great in the shimmer blue color. It comes with following dimensions, which is very slim and weighs 179 grams. The build quality from the glass metal sandwich is great, which feels solid and offers great in-hand feel. The display features 6.56-inch Full HD Plus AMOLED panel with HDR10+ that offers excellent quality, and the panel features 120Hz refresh rate, which is very smooth. Also, the display offers great colors, contrast and dynamic range along with great sharpness. The sunlight visibility is excellent as well. The hardware features Qualcomm's Snapdragon 870 SoC with 12GB RAM and 256GB storage, which is not expandable. It comes with all the important sensors including gyroscope, and the in-display fingerprint scanner works very well. The software features Android 11 with custom FunTouch OS interface, which includes stock Android-like interface with app drawer and more. The connectivity features include recent versions of Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and 5G, and it also features NFC. The audio quality is great from the single speaker and via earphones that came in the box. Also, the volume level is pretty great but could have been a little higher. The overall performance is excellent, the interface is very smooth, web browsing experience is excellent, apps and games load very quickly, multitasking is excellent, and my favorite part, the RAM management is excellent as well thanks to the virtual RAM. To know more about this feature, you can watch my Vivo X60 Pro Plus video. Also, the gaming performance is excellent with very consistent frame rates and very smooth gameplay from both the games, Asphalt 9 and Call of Duty, in max graphics settings. The triple rear cameras features a 48MP primary lens with f1.5 aperture, a 13MP telephoto lens with f2.5 aperture, and a 13MP ultra-wide lens with f2.2 aperture, which also doubles up as a macro lens, while the front camera features a 32MP primary lens with f2.5 aperture. The rear camera can record videos up to 4K at 60fps, while the front camera can record videos up to Full HD at 30fps. These are the additional camera features on offer. In daylight, the overall camera performance is excellent, with plenty of details, colors, and dynamic range. Recording this part of the video on Vivo X60 Pro main camera in Full HD at 60fps. The video stabilization is excellent thanks to gimbal OIS and EIS stabilization options. Recording this part of the video on Vivo X60 Pro front camera in Full HD at 30 fps. In low light, the overall camera performance is very good, but could have been still better. The device comes with 4200mAh battery and the battery life is pretty great. During my quick intensive usage, I got a screen on time of 1 hour 20 minutes with the battery percentage which dropped from 80 to 60%. So you can expect up to 6 hours 30 minutes of average screen on time, which is pretty great but could have been better if it had come with a slightly bigger battery. The charging time from 0 to 100% from the 33W fast charger should be about 65 minutes. Which is pretty great. These are the pros and cons. For product rating, I would rate 8.53 out of 10. For VFM rating, I would rate 6.6 out of 10. So Gadget Gurubayan rating is 7.56 out of 10. After considering all the pros, cons and ratings, it's a great smartphone at a pretty good price, which is definitely on the premium side. But on the whole, it's still a pretty great flagship smartphone for sure. That's it for this video. I hope you found this review useful and I'll see you guys in the next video.